Hi everybody and welcome back. So we are inside today. It is pouring rain outside and I will take it because it's not snowing, it's raining. Thank goodness. It's actually in the low 50s today. I think it was 52 degrees last time I checked, which is awesome. But I don't know if you hear that very exciting noise in the background. Our chicks came in. We're expanding the flock this year. They came in this morning. I did not do an unboxing video because they had about a day and a half flight in, and I just wanted to get them out and into a cozy place and get them watered and fed and all that good stuff. They did really well. We had ordered 20 chickens. They came in 24 chickens. Only one sadly passed away along the ride. And everybody else is doing really well so far. When we got them in, I gave them water first, just to get their bodies hydrated and that kind of thing. And then we moved on to the food a little while later after everybody was able to get a drink so they could digest a little bit easier. I figured that was the best route to go. But these guys are Plymouth Barred Rocks, and I love these chickens. I have always wanted these chickens. To me, they are like a symbol of the American homesteader. They are supposed to be absolutely wonderful for eggs and for me. Outside right now, if you guys have seen our other chicken videos, we have Buff Brahmas, who are also wonderful for eggs and meat. And I've actually was doing some reading, and people have actually bred these two breeds together in order to make like the perfect chicken kind of thing. So I'm really, really excited to have these chickens. As you can see, there are a lot of them here, and we'll have that in upcoming videos because we already have it all planned out and everything. We are making a new permanent coop that all the chickens will go in together, that will have a breeder on the side and all that good stuff, and a grow out pen. We're very, very excited about that. The coops that we have out there were basically made for transportation. We were in between homes, so they were built quickly and to be able to be moved from place to place and all that good stuff. So we're finally going to build our big permanent coop to have a large flock. We did get these guys through Tractor Supply. I had looked at two other hatcheries, trying to support other hatcheries, but being up here in New England, when I type, I had it all ordered out, ready to go, and I typed into ship, they weren't going to be able to ship to us until summer. Getting a little drink over here. Yum, yum. And then I checked another hatchery, and they had issues with getting them out to us, so we did end up going with Tractor Supply. I am very happy with how it all turned out. They called me at 6:30 this morning that they were at the post office. I went and picked them right up, brought them home. Everybody except for the one chick was doing really well. Like I said, they put in the extra four because we did order 20 chickens. Originally, we weren't going to do that many chickens. What we wanted was 10 females and 2 roosters, just in case one of the roosters didn't survive, to make sure that we had a good full-bred rooster, so that if we ever want to separate the two breeds and breed for full-bred, we can. With Tractor Supply, though, because of all the issues with people coming in around Easter and ordering chicks for their children, they have minimum orders of 10, and everything is 10. It's not something where you can buy, oh, 2 of these and 2 of those and 1 of those until it equals up to 10. If you want 10 female, or if you want 1 female barred rock, you're getting 10 of them. Same with the male, same with the unsexed. So we did a lot of discussing, and what we did was we decided to do 1 order of 10 females. So unless that one that had passed away was a female, 10 of these guys are going to be hens. And then the other 10, we decided to do a straight run in hopes that at least one of them will be a survivable good rooster. Any other roosters will be table birds. We'll bring the hens up, and then we'll make some choices about who's laying out of the flocks, who's not, how many of the extra hens do we want to keep, and who do we want to be table birds. So that is the plan going forward, so we'll have a lot to look forward to with these guys and videos, building the coops and all that good stuff. But I must say I am very, very happy. I was praying that everybody came in nice and healthy and happy and well, and so far so good. We're still on day 1, but everyone has seemed very lively. I haven't noticed anybody that's been overly lazy or not eating or laying down too much. I've been checking on them a lot through the day, cleaning shavings out of their water and all that good stuff. Everybody seems good, so we'll be having updates on these guys coming along as they grow up, as well as the seedlings, which I'm actually down here working on some more of those today. So lots going on with spring coming. It's trying. As you guys know, we've been having snow, but it's trying. It's going to be here. I can't wait. I know, you are adorable. Alright guys, well, I just wanted to share this with you, so thank you so much for joining. If you like this video, please hit that like button. It helps us out a ton. And always think about subscribing. Otherwise, I do appreciate any and all support. And we love you all. We hope you enjoy the rest of your day. God bless, and bye-bye.